guys, my name's Dave and welcome to another Guitar Zero to Hero song tutorial. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to play Fat Lip by Sum 41, which is one of my favorite pop punk songs of all time. If you want to master your chords back to front, then be sure to head over to guitarzerotohero.com to pick up my free guitar ebook. Or if you want to improve on your guitar, then sign up to Guitar Zero to Hero Premium, which is my complete step-by-step guitar course. Now, for the basics of this song, you will need to tune your guitar to drop D tuning. So that just involves taking your low E string down to a D. That's the only string you'll need to detune, and then we're good to go. All right, let's jump into the lesson. Now, in terms of tone, I'm recording everything using the Boss Katana. If you want to download the patch that I'm using, then I'll leave a link to that in the description below. But you will need a Katana in order to open that file. But if you want to get something similar, but what I've done, I'm obviously using a Les Paul here. I'm using the bridge pickup. I've got my tone and volume all the way up to 10. Now on the amp settings, I'm using just a clean amp on the Katana and I'm using a distortion pedal in front of it, and that's pretty much it. You could get a similar effect by using a high gain amp with your gain cranked up, and then you don't really need the distortion pedal. But that's the setup I'm running with my Katana patch. Let's start with the intro, and this is a whole lot of fun to play. So we're gonna start with the 6th fret of the 6th string, and we're going to palm mute the first 3 notes. So to palm mute, take the fleshy bit of your palm, rest it lightly on the edge of the bridge, and then when you pluck individual notes, you get that nice chunk. So if you go too far in, nothing will ring out. So it just needs to be right on the edge of the bridge. So we're gonna pluck the 6th fret, then 7th fret, and then 9th fret with your pinky. So I do that all with down plucks. Then you go up to the 6th fret of the 4th string, and you hit that with no palm muting. So that bar in total. Now the 2nd bar is almost identical, except the end note is not the 6th fret of the 4th string, it's now the 9th fret of the 5th. The 3rd bar is identical to the 1st bar. And then the 4th bar is nearly the same as the 2nd bar, except we add one note, which is the 7th fret of the 5th string. So 9, 7 to end that 4th bar. So the riff in total. Now notice that the first 3 notes of each of the bars is palm muted, and that's it for the intro. One more time. Now, when the full band kicks in, we're just gonna keep playing that riff for the lead guitar. There's a rhythm guitar that I'll teach you what's going on there in a sec, but when the band kicks in, we're just gonna keep playing that riff, except now we don't need to palm mute any of those notes. So it's just. Again and again. For the rhythm guitar, there's some lead-in strumming here, which is just an A5 power chord. So just, you can either play like this or you can bar your index finger across the 2nd fret of the 4th and 3rd strings, just with a down, down. That's a sort of lead-in strumming. And then the full band kicks in. So we're gonna play the open power chord, and then 2nd fret power chord. Now remember, we're in drop D, so you just need to bar your index finger across the top 3 strings. So we hit that twice. And then to end this bar, we're going to do it again, but with an up strum. So it'll sound like this. And then the 2nd bar is open, 2nd fret, and then the A5 power chord. So that main riff. And you just repeat that again and again. And that's the rhythm part for the intro. Now we move on to the verse, which is a lot of fun to play. So we're gonna start with our 2nd fret power chord like this. We're gonna strum this with a down and then quickly mute it. You don't want that ringing out. Then we're gonna play octaves up here at the 7th and 9th fret on the 5th and 3rd strings. You're gonna hit that and slide down 1 fret. And then slide it back up to the 9th and 7th and hit again. Like that. And then we go to the 9th fret power chord. I like to play this with my ring finger, like this, and we hit it twice. So the first two bars. And then we go to the 7th fret power chord, hit that with it. We're gonna do the same octave slide down and up. And then we go 7th, 6th of the 6th string. So the riff in total. And that's it for the verse riff. For the pre-chorus, we have just power chords and some fast palm muting here. So we're gonna start with the 2nd fret power chord like this. Now we're going to do down strums at 8th notes, so 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. It's all palm muted except for the 2 beat and the 4 beat. So 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And you're gonna do that for 2 bars on this power chord. And then we go to a C sharp power chord like this, so 4th and 6th fret. Do that for one strumming pattern. And then go down to our A for one pattern. So again, so the 2 and the 4 beat, so listen out for that snare, that's where you're going to open up and not palm mute, so. Notice how I lift my hand when I'm doing that accented strum. I'm not palm muting there. Now you might have to practice this quite slow and work your way up because it is quite fast. But the second line of tab is almost identical except for the A. When we get to the A, we're just gonna strum with the da, 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 da. So the pre-chorus in total. Next we get to the chorus. I'm gonna start by teaching you the lead and then we can move to the rhythm. So the lead starts with an octave up at the 11th and 13th frets. With octaves, remember you only want those notes that you're pushing down to ring out. So everything else can be muted by lightly resting your fingers over the top of the other strings. So we have 11th and 13th, so down, and then down, and next up down, we're going to slide down 2 frets. And then we're going to do the exact same thing down another 2 frets. So. Then we finish with a down, down, down on the 7th and 9th octave. So all together. And then we go down to the 6th and 8th with a down. Our next 3 strums are down. And on the next up down, we go back up. So the first 4 strums. And then the next 3 strums is 7th and 9th and back down. And then back up. And then we end with 2 strums on the 7th and 9th octave. So the last 2 bars. So it kind of just sort of follows the vocal melody in terms of the rhythm. So in total. And you just repeat that again and again in the chorus. Now let's move on to the rhythm for the chorus. And it's just power chords here. We're gonna start with our 2nd fret power chord here with a down, down. Then on our next up down, we're going to go just to a B5 power chord like this. Then we're going to go another down strum on that and then slide up 2 frets with the up down. So. And then we end with a down, down, down. So. And then we go to the sixth fret power chord like this on the sixth string. We're gonna go. And then the opposite way. And you're gonna kind of follow the rhythm of the vocals again with sixth fret and seventh fret. And in total for the chorus rhythm. The next part we're gonna learn is post-chorus two. So it's quite rhythmic, it's very basic, but it is rhythmic. So we're gonna start this second fret power chord with a down. Then we have two mutes with an up down. So it's not down up, it's up down, all right? Now that's important just because with the rhythm, it makes more sense. So down, up down. So that's that bar in total. We have another up down mute, and then another power chord for the second bar. So it sounds like this. The third and fourth bar are almost identical, except instead of going back to this second fret power chord, we go to the A power chord and let it ring out. So the first line of tab. The second line of tabs identical, except we just cut out the final bar. Everything just stops there. Next we get to the clean bridge, which is a lot of fun to play. So we need an E power chord like this on the fifth string, so seventh and ninth frets. I'm gonna start like that. We're going to pluck the fifth, fourth, third, and back to fourth. So for our next bar, just slide your index finger down one fret. Everything else stays the same. Then we go to a C minor bar chord like this. We're gonna pluck fifth, fourth, second, fourth. And then we end with the A5 power chord like this. So you just need your index finger on the second fret of the fourth string, effectively. And we're going to pluck fifth, fourth, fifth. And that's the riff in total. Fun riff to play, and that's on a clean channel. Next we get to the rock out bridge section, and it's quite similar to the intro rhythm that sounds like this. It's just that riff that we sort of had in the intro, and obviously there's some specific accents, but to follow along just go to the playthrough at the end and you'll see what I mean by those accents and pauses. Finally, there's a build up into the final chorus, and it's quite simple. It's just an open power chord for two bars, and we're palm muting this at eighth notes, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for two bars like that, and then for the next two bars, you put your ring finger on the fifth fret of the fifth string. So instead of palm muting, start opening it up and hitting full strings. Like that. And those are all the parts to Fat Lip by Sum 41. So now I'll be doing a full playthrough of the song, and I'll have a vocal track on top for some context. A big thanks to my friend Tugler for lending his awesome vocals to this playthrough. If you want to check out his YouTube channel, there's a link in the description below. Feel free to play this back as many times as you'd like to practice, play along to, and see how you go. Buddy, go. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to head over to guitarzeroadohero.com to pick up my free guitar ebook. Or if you want to improve on your guitar, then sign up to Guitar Zero to Hero Premium, which is my complete step-by-step guitar course. It'd mean the world if you could hit that like button, hit subscribe, click the little notification bell as well so that you don't miss out on my updates. Please leave your thoughts, comments, questions, or requests down below, and I'll see you guys next time on Guitar Zero to Hero. Cheers.